Assalamu alaikum and welcome to mathematics class for standard 7th, chapter 6, the triangle and its properties, recapitulation for PT2 examination. Students, what you are going to learn from this video? In this video, I'll be explaining you some of the properties again. It is a recap. So, all the properties which are there in the chapter in a short recap with four different sums I had taught to you. So what are we waiting for? Let's go for it. Okay students, so the first question of the recap is find the value of x in the given diagram. Now this is the diagram. Okay student, and triangle and its properties is the chapter where we are dealing with the different properties which are valid for all the triangles, right? Except one, that is the Pythagoras, which is valid only for the right angle triangle. So let us begin this property. Now students, I want to show you that if the triangle is like this, so as you could see, this is a triangle with one of the side produced ahead, and when the side is produced ahead, we get one angle outside the triangle, that is angle X, correct? So this angle X is outside the triangle, which is called as exterior angle. We have to find the value of this X. Now, as this is an exterior angle, we have exterior angle property, that is equal to the sum of interior and opposite angles. Now, as you could see, in the interior of the triangle, we can get three angles. One is 30, one is 40, and one is this one, which is adjacent to X. But this adjacent angle is never taken for exterior angle property. So leaving this angle, we have to add the interior opposite angles, and the sum of these two angles is equal to the exterior angle. This is the property which is called as the exterior angle property. So now let us start writing how we are going to write it down. So let's begin with answer. Now, in the given triangle, as the triangle is not been named, here it could have been A, B, C or X, Y, Z, L, M, N, whatever. But the names are not given. So, if names are not given, we will mention in the given triangle. Right? We will write by exterior angle property. This we have to mention because we have to write down that which property you are using to solve this. So by exterior angle property, we have angle X is equal to angle 30 degree plus angle of 40 degree. So, if you are going to add them, we have angle of 70 degrees. So, therefore, what is the value of X? X is nothing but it is equal to 70 degrees. So, this is how we have found the value of X. Understood, student? See, the property which you are using, you have to mention it. It is carrying certain weightages, right? Similarly, your answers, right? So, be sure that whenever you are solving the things, you are mentioning the properties. Now, let us move ahead. Okay, students, so your next question number 2 is like this. Find the value of X in the given diagram. So, here is the diagram of a triangle A, B, C. So, name of the triangle is given to you in this diagram, correct? And in the triangle, x is there. Now this x is not exterior angle, it is inside the triangle, so this is interior angle, right? Now how many interior angles in a triangle we have? Always you have three angles, one angle, two angle and third angle, right? So first, second and third angle, all three angles are being marked here. The first angle is given with the measurement 30 degree, second angle given with the measurement 110 degree, and third angle is x. We have to find the value of this x. So inside, if three angles are there and out of that two are given and only one is unknown, then we can make use of angle sum property of a triangle. Now what is angle sum property of a triangle? It is the sum of all the three angles of a triangle is always supplementary. That means the sum of angle A, B and C is equal to 180 degree. So let us start solving it. Answer. Now as here the name of the triangle is given, we are going to mention the name in triangle ABC by angle sum property. Now what is angle sum property? Angle sum property is angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. Done. Now in the place of A, let us write down the measure of angle A, that is 30 degree. Now in the place of B, let us write down the measure of angle B, that is 110 degree. And in the place of C, let us write down the measure of angle, which is not given here, but a letter is given. So let us write down the letter X is equals to 180 degree. Now after adding 30 and 110, what answer you get? Correct. 140 degree plus x as it is, because here the answer of 30 and 40 we have written here, the rest of all things will be same. Now this x is equals to 180. Now where is this 140? After transposing it to the other side of equality, you have to change the sign, right? So 140 is in positive sign here, no sign is given, so what you will consider? Plus. So this 140, after transposing here near 180, it will become negative 140 degree. Okay students, now you deduct 140 from 180. That means you have to minus 180 and 140. So what answer you get? Correct, you get only 40 degree. So in this manner you got the value of x, right, by using the angle sum property. Understood student? So it may happen that the triangle's name may change, the position may change, the numbers of the measure of angles may change, but the method will remain the same if x is in the interior of any triangle. Right student? So now let us move ahead. Students, now the third question is it possible to have a triangle with the following sides? Now let us check that whether the given length of the side of a triangle makes a triangle, is it possible or not? Now to check this, what we have to use we have to use the property of the sum of the length of two sides of a triangle must be greater than the third, than the length of the third side, right? So let us use this property. We'll write answer. We know that the sum of the length of lengths of two sides of a triangle must be greater than the length of its third side. Right? So let us check by applying this property in three different ways. Because if out of the three ways any one is not valid, then the triangle is not possible. All three ways the property should be valid. Then and then only we can say that the length of the given triangle makes a proper triangle. Okay, students, so let us start by adding 5 plus 6. Number 1, is 5 plus 6 is greater than 10? So let us check. 5 plus 6 is 11 and 11 is greater than 10. So what we are going to write? Yes, here 11, that is the sum of two sides, is greater than the third side. Now let us check for the another two. Okay, second, that is, now I am adding 6 plus 10 greater than 5. That means now taking first 5, 6 taken one addition and greater than 3. Now we are going to move 6 plus 10 greater than 5. So all the three ways we have to add, right? So is it possible? Let's see. 6 plus 10 is 16 and 16 is greater than 5. So here also we are getting the properties validation. Now let us move to the next one. It should be possible with all the three ways. Now we are going to take 10 and 5, that is addition of this and this, greater than 6. So let us take now 10 plus 5 is greater than 6. Is it possible? Let's see. 10 plus 5 gives you 15, right? And 15 is greater than 6. So we are going to write yes, it is possible. See, all three ways the addition is actually greater than the left third side. So we can say that, therefore, now if the question is it possible to have a triangle with these following sides? So we will write yes, the given triangle is possible Yes, the given triangle is possible. That's it. So this is the end of your question. That is, that is it possible to have the triangle with three sides? And we have to mention all this is the way of doing the sum. Now let us move ahead, students. The next question is number 4. That is, in triangle ABC, right angled at C, if AC is 5 cm, BC is 12 cm, then find the length of AB. As students, you can see that only word problem is there and we have no figure here. So it is mandatory for you to draw the figure. So let us draw the figure, students. As it is a right angle triangle, So let us make one right angle triangle here. So drawing the figure, make it easy for us. As you could see, I can write this sharp perpendicular side is actually a 90 degree angle is forming here. Now accordingly here, as it said that this is a triangle ABC. Now where A will come, where B will come, where C will come, this statement will tell us right angled at C. If it is written right angled at C, that means 90 degree is at C. So we can write C here. Now what letters are left if C is written? A and B. You may write anyhow. You write A here, you write B here, you write A here, you write B here. It is one and the same. So I am writing A here and B here. Now my lengths are also matching. See, my AC, that is the short side. So that is 5 cm. Now accordingly, if I would have written A here, AC is longer than A. Right, AC is longer than BC, so it should not happen. Your BC is the longest side, so BC you have to mention here. Here I am going to write 12 cm, that is the length of BC, and AC is having 5 cm. What you have to find? You have to find the length of A and B. As you could see here, the length of A and B, students, right? Now let us begin how to write it down. Now as you know, this is a right angle triangle. So which property is valid here? Correct, by Pythagoras theorem, right? That is by Pythagoras property we can write. So let us write down, in triangle ABC, right? Now what property you are using, you have to write down. By Pythagoras. If you want to write theorem, you may write theorem. If you want to write property, you may write property. Both the words are valid. By Pythagoras property. Now what is Pythagoras property? Sum of perpendicular side, that means sum of the length of two perpendicular side, is always equal to the square of the hypotenuse. Sum of square of perpendicular side is equal to the square of hypotenuse. Or you may also write that sum of square of two side is equal to. Now that property, if you are going to write it in words, no need here. We are going to directly mention that which perpendicular sides you are taking. We can say that hypotenuse square, AB square, is equals to one side square plus other side square, that is AC square and BC square. These are the two sides which are going to squared and then added. Okay, so we are going to get the square of AB, and then we will be finding the root of AB. So that will give us the length of AB. Now I'm going to put the values of AC. AC is here 5 cm. So let us write down 5 and let us square it. BC is 12, so let us write down 12 and square it. Now 5 square is 25 and 12 square is 144. After adding, what you get? 104 plus 2 gives you 6, and 4 plus 5 will give you 9. Now as you could see here, AB square you got as 169, but you want only AB, you don't want square, right? So do the square root of 169, that is 13 multiply by 13. So inside the root, if it is 2 13s, so outside the root only 1 13 will come, that is 13 cm. Now here it was asked, find the length of AB. So we are going to write length. The length of AB is 13 cm. So this is how we have solved with the sum, right? This is the sum done completely. Okay, students.
Thank you, students, for watching the video. I hope you have understood all the four properties. Of course, you have to go through all the textbook properties, all the sums, my videos, the PDF, and the worksheet questions, right, student? Yes, definitely, the questions are changed with the digit, but the method remains the same. Good luck from my side. In the description box of this video, you're going to find the link of all the videos which are belonging to the chapter, the triangle and its properties. Okay, so any of the explanation, if you want a recap, you may just go through the link in the description box. Watch any of the explanation you want. Good luck once again. Have a nice day. Goodbye.